is that 40 plus shit. So if you're under 40,
it's that 40 plus.
It's that 40 plus. You've been, we're in the clubs for so long. I definitely had like bad drug years and eating like shit. I had a heart attack like 10
yeah.
years ago.
I saw that, yeah, man.
After your first tour with yes. Wiz, after you had a stroke?
No, no, heart attack.
Heart attack.
Yeah.
What the f- what was
let's
it?
Talk about that, yeah.
I mean, was it just
you want to hear it real quick?
Like, yeah. Blacking right. the so, fuck out, right?
I went
like, yo, you had to learn on your first tour, like God that's was looking down and like, yo, you wilding out a little too
these
much.
Guys, they're all laughing. Too much good. No, yeah. but I'll tell you, dude. Because
I know you must have been wilding
too much of a good time.
Listen,
someone listen to it. Because
the first tour, it wasn't even like the third.
It was
the
no, first. It was the first.
This is when Black and Yellow was at his height.
I'm going to tell you this. So imagine dropping Black and Yellow and the Steelers go to the Super Bowl, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So wait, it was our first tour. And I probably smoked a shitload of weed, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Wiz Khalifa, Kush and Orange Juice, first tour. Oh, yes. So everyone's trying to smoke with Wiz. So like every tour, like people are literally bringing you weed. And I mean, it's crazy. So fast forward, 3 month tour. We get back to Pittsburgh. We're like heroes. I'm DJing. And all of a sudden, like I've never like left a DJ gig because I wasn't feeling good.
Mm.
And I felt like I wasn't having a deep breath. Like I was just like, shit, I just don't feel right. Like I literally left the gig and I went home and I quit my full-time job in radio. So I didn't have health benefits at all.
Oh shit.
And so I was scared to go to the shit. And so for 2 or 3 days I was like, like why can't I breathe? But I had pride, you know. Yeah. Like I don't want to go to that. That's crazy. Like
pride,
I don't want to go to
pride and fear, right?
Pride
right.
and fear.
Yeah.
And I actually thought I must have busted a lung. Like that's what I really thought. Like you know, like oh shit, I smoked this fucking weed and maybe my
lung is
yeah,
broken.
My lung is broken. Like
out of service,
maybe it's green, you know. So so we finally decided. Like I woke up one of the nights. It was like the third night, and I woke up. My back is on fire, and I'm like, fuck, like something's not right. So I'm like, fuck it, let's go to the clinic because the clinic.
Let's go to the clinic.
Not, I mean, I was trying to avoid yeah. the hospital
yeah,
bill, man.
Exactly,
like period.
Yeah.
And so I went to the clinic and I was like, all right. And weed wasn't like, you weren't that open about weed then. Like if I went to the clinic today, I'd be like, I right. smoked hella weed. But I was like, I went on this tour with Wiz Khalifa and I smoked weed. So I think there's something wrong yeah. with me, you know? And they did like a lung thing. And they like checked my lungs and shit. And they were like, nothing's wrong. But they're like, since we can't find anything, we're going to send you to the emergency room.
Oh.
And I think they knew, but didn't want to tell me. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Scare the shit
yeah,
out of
exactly. Because the ambulance came. They gave me one of them pills, I think, that they give real old people to pop just in case they think they're having a heart attack. I think it was that. And
it
I
like
get,
brings your blood pressure
yeah,
down.
Something
right?
like
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
I get to the hospital. The heart doctor had already left, but he came back and he's just like, you had a heart attack this morning. I'm like, fuck,
what?
You know? And then imagine he had to
man.
Call my mom and my sister and was like, and they lived in Philly. They're like, your son had a heart attack. We got to put him, he's got to get a stent in his heart. And so when you hear like quadruple bypass or whatever, that's like how many stents that you need. And I just had one and I had a 99% blocked artery.
From
I don't know.
Just dietary?
I mean, it could have been like, honestly, they can't really tell you,
that's
you know, it
scary.
Could be Filipino diet. I was definitely heavy as, I was probably 230 pounds. You know, my family has diabetes. I mean, I'll just say it. I was doing drugs,
right.
You know, around the time. And but I also know people who treat themselves crazy, like eat
man.
Whatever they want, drugs as much as they want. These motherfuckers are still, so I'm just kind of like, I like to look at it as,
you're,
you know,
31 at the
30
time?
Like 30
okay.
I think I'm 30 and I just like, it's a kiss from God, man. Just like,
right,
you know, I don't know if it was a slowdown, because literally after that year was like the greatest year that I've had as far as DJing with Wiz and touring in Europe and MTV and all this shit. So honestly, I think it was I call it the debt to the blessings, man.
Wow.
Look, we all can't have, like, we are all under this program that we think that our lives should just always be here. And it needs to come in waves, and we have to sleep, right? And the
mm-hmm.
sun has to come up, and the moon. And so right now, I'm on this, like, different path of health and kind of changing my mind about a lot of things. But I just want you guys to welcome these low points in your life and not
yeah.
to define them as low points, just necessary.
That's great.
You
that's
know?
All. Yeah. That's. I feel like a lot of young motherfuckers need to know that,
because they want to, especially
it's
like DJs. They want to dodge.
Story.
They just trying to dodge. They want to
yeah.
have this perfect, like, No,
but they're so hard on themselves too. Right. You know, because no one ever documents the failure.
Right.
So when they have a failure, they think it's over.
Right.
And it, they have to.
And how many failures have you had?
So many.
Exactly.
Yeah. I had a recent failure.
Let's hear it.
A different failure every week. Like, you know what I'm saying? Right. Like,
as far as what? Just.
That's like you were saying young people. I feel like everyone should be listening to this right now because everyone's like going.
No one likes to talk about the failures.
Yeah.
It's almost like a.
But I'm embracing them. I constantly am. I try to tell people constantly, like, I'm not perfect. I have to be one part of that has a platform that explains to people, like, I welcome these things. You know, there's been a lot of like. It sounds crazy, but the first time I ever played Mac Miller on the radio, there was like
rest in peace, Mac Miller.
Rest in peace. I was the first person to ever play him on the radio, and it fucked up. There was like two songs. I don't know if y'all ever done radio before, but it fucked up, and there was two songs playing at the same time, and because I was pre-recorded,
right?
And so I look at those things like people like I saw Lizzo perform at Coachella. You know, before the pandemic, and her mic went out and it was terrible. And I'm always like, those are fine signs of great things coming. Mm. You know, most people want to look at those shits and be like, my shit's over. But it's like, yo, nobody wants to read a story that's like chapter one and he lived happily ever after. You know what I'm saying? That's why I'm
here. That's deep, man.
You know,
but
I mean,
you don't even want to really hang out with motherfuckers who haven't failed because they are the biggest.
Well, not even that they haven't failed. Yeah, there's a lot of, I'm just saying this out loud, I know names or whatever, but there's a lot of people out there.
Who haven't struggled.
They've struggled, but they just.
They don't talk about it.
Well, they just keep positioning themselves as like your God's gift to DJing in their city. Like, dog, you've held that residency down for 25 years. Like, what's changed? You know what I'm saying? Like,
Bonix, are you high right now?
No.
I can't imagine him being high.
I see, you have something, I got it, but it's empty.
No, because I was like, imagine when he's high. If he's this deep shit right now, imagine when he's fucking blown. That shit would be insane.
I hate to be, you know, I kept thinking before I got in here, I'm like, man, I got a lot of opinions. Like, I don't want anyone to hate me for it or whatever. But honestly, man, we got to start looking and acting like a community.
If you want to check the full episode of this clip, click the video on the left. Or if you'd like to continue watching more road clips, click the video on the right. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube page and get updated on new clips and videos from Road Podcast throughout the week. Peace.